Let's learn about the servo motor. It's model airplane. A servo motor is used as a steering to control this RC car. Or servo is used in RC boat. This course is based on SunFounder 3-in-1 Arduino kit sold on Amazon. Everything that you learn in this course is included in this kit. The course comes with tons of components and projects, all with instruction and video for smart car and other projects that you can use for school or home automation. You can purchase it from sunfounder.com. The kit also comes with full documentation, code download, learning projects with full explanation, wiring diagram, and the code that you can download. A link to purchase the kit and documentation is below the video in the description. Welcome to Arduino course by Robojax. For RC boat, you can control the direction and altitude of RC plane. And here you can see that it two servos used here to control the direction of this RC plane. And this robotic arm servo is used for a hand grip. And also you see here one servo, another servo, another servo, another servo to rotate this robotic arm in different direction, up and down, left to right, in 6 different directions. This is a servo motor also. This is very large with comparing to this micro servo. I'm gonna display this one. The amount of torque that each generate will determine the quality and the price of the servo and also the size. For example, this can be used for the steering of a very powerful RC car, but this would be for small airplane or a small RC car. When you purchase it, usually they ship it with this half arm or maybe this type of arm or that type of arm that doesn't have this. So these can be used for different purposes, and you can attach and you can detach them and put them at any direction. And using Arduino or other means, either RC remote control, you can change the direction of the servo. And from inside you can also see the gears. Or you might attach this small arm for different purpose like this. The servo has 3 wires, for example in this servo. The middle pin is always the power wire. In this case, this servo is 5 volts, and you have to look at the data sheet of the servo to get and check it what is the voltage. Usually it's 5 volts, but 6 and other voltages are available. This servo is 5 volts, and the middle, this is a positive. This darker color is the ground. They put the positive at the middle because even if you connect it incorrectly or insert it in different position, the middle is always positive, so the device is protected against the incorrect polarity. The last one is a signal that you control the servo. From here you send the signal. It has a motor inside it, a servo motor, and this rotates 180 degrees. Servos will come with different arms that can be attached to it. For example, you can attach some, if you need to control two parts of something, you can connect a string or a rod here through these holes or here, and or maybe adjust it at different values, at different length from the center. So this is called the radius, and this will be attached, and then there will be a screw that you can see I'm moving it with hand. So if you just remember this point, now it just goes 180 degrees, so it can come back, but it doesn't go full rotation. Just need, if you don't need the other side, you can just use this one. So the servo is very useful for a lot of application in robotics. Here is the wiring using first thing. This is a servo motor connected to Arduino. The signal wire have been connected to pin 9. The middle wire, which is a VCC or power, have been connected to 5 volts, and the ground have been connected to the ground. Now let me explain the wiring. This is called the servo connector, which has 3 pins, and this is the female type, and there are also the male type of this. But the servo that you receive always will have this female connector. Now I'm connecting it to this 3 wires, the DuPont male to male. Here, this is a ground brown. The wire that I put is blue, and this is connected to the ground of Arduino. And the middle one, the green, is the power, which is in here, that is connected here to 5 volts of Arduino. And the last pin, which is the signal for Arduino, this is connected to pin 9. To run servo or control it, click on file, example, and scroll down until you see servo. And here there is one sweep, one is knob. Let's open first the sweep, including the servo.h header file, and this is used to control the servo. And then you put the name of the header file. This is a class, and this is, you're creating an instance of the class, and here it's called my servo. And the next line, integer pose, that's a position, that's a variable that's holding the position, and initial position is 0. And inside the setup, we have to attach the servo to the program. My servo, the same name that you have here, my servo.attach 9. In this case, this example shows that the servo is connected to pin 9. And if you have multiple servos, you just put this line in the next one and then change this number, different pin. And inside the loop here that starts from here to here, we have a for loop, one for loop, and then another for loop. This for loop checks the position initially at 0, and this is for comparison. It compares that position is, if it's smaller than or equal to 180, then position will be incremented by 1. And then my servo dot right, when you put dot right, this moves the servo to the position that you put here. Because this position is, this is a loop and increments 1 by 1, it starts from 0 and goes up to 180. So this value is changing between 0 to 180. And when this is sent to the servo, servo moves to that position in terms of degree, and then waits for 15 milliseconds, so the servo have enough time to move, and then it continues again and moves it one more degree, increasing from 0 to 180. When it reaches 180, then exits. Now this, then this loop take effect. Initial position of this one is 180, and it checks if it's bigger than 0, which is true, and then that it's subtracting the value, decrementing it. And initially it writes at 180 because this was 180. Now it writes it at 180, and then comes back, subtract, this has become 179, 178, 77, and so forth until it reaches 0, then the loop exits. The servo has been moved back to the position 0. This starts from 0 to 180, and here it starts from 180 to 0. It comes back, it does the same thing all over again. Now I will upload the code. I'm uploading the code. Once the code is uploaded, this will continuously start rotating. Let's see when the upload is finished. You will see the blanks. Okay, so this side is 180 and this side is 0. I can remove and put it properly. Now I've put it such that this is 0 and that is 180. And this is the code that it controls it. Because this is a loop in your application, you will not read it. This is just for learning purpose. So you will use this one to set the servo at any angle you want. I'm now deleting this. Put it like this, for example, 90 degrees. Upload. So it turned to 90 degrees. If I want it to 0 degrees, let me upload it. Now it's at 0. So the 0 for the servo is in here. If I put 180, it should turn in this area and wait. This way you can control a servo motor with any angle that you want, and it rotates up to here. That's 90, that's 180. So if 90 is here, 120 should be somewhere in here. Now I'm bringing back this code, and this time instead of 1, let's move it 20 degrees clockwise from 0 to 180, that is 0 and 180. So we say go 20, 20, 20, and it will not reach 180, but when it goes back, we say go 5 degrees, because this is a step or increments. Let me upload it. Now this is very fast and it doesn't give enough time. Let's give it a little time, 100 millisecond, and give it also 100 millisecond. Now you see from this side it goes 5, from here it goes 20, reaches very quick. Before it was not able to do it because 15 millisecond was too fast and it was just sticking in this area. Now it goes a full direction. You see this is very smooth because it goes 5. Now here it's fast, 5, 5, 5, 5, and then 20, 20, 20. You can go even 60 degrees, like by 3 move, it should reach there and make this 25 degrees. You see, 3 move was the other way, and this is 25 degrees. Now 1, 2, 3, because I said 60, 60 times 3 is 180. This is 20 degrees each, 25, and that is now 60. And here is example of another servo motor.